Warning.
The following
video
video
is
is not intended for an audience
under
the age of 13.
Do not watch
the
video
without a guardian
or
parent
present.
That is all.
Rumble is red, Frenzy is blue, and I've got a Rejecticon response video for you. Hey gang, Firebite27 here today, and, well, a YouTube user by the name of Rejecticon has set forth a challenge for reviewers to show off their review space. And I wasn't aware of this challenge until today, in fact, when I watched Patriot Prime's video going over this challenge, so I figured why not jump on the bandwagon and do the same. Now then, the challenge will include, in this video at least, a tour of my workspace. Don't expect to get a good look at the floor, it's a mess. But it will give you some idea of where I record in and what I do. So, without further ado, let's get on with it!
The first thing I wanted to get a good look at before I got any further with the video was my tripod, because honestly, that's... Well, I'm gonna be using it for the rest of the video, so probably a good idea to just get that on camera first. Okay, this is my bed where I sleep, sometimes where I eat lunch and snack. There's a box of BotBots that I sometimes fiddle around with. And it's also where I do reviews and, well, do most of my editing on that computer. Isn't that interesting? I think it is. There we go. Now then, the first thing I want to show you is basically the space where I get most of my photos for reviews taken. There is my light box. That's where I take most of the photos, like the ones you saw in the last episode of It Figures. You can see it's still got my little Lego arcade in that. Fun fact, yesterday, shortly after I premiered the video, I watched a stream by the Lazy Eyebrow reviewer in which I asked him if he wanted me to send him sort of like instructions on how to build those arcade machines. And he said yes, and so I sent him an email with them, and so there's that. You can see that I've got, like, some random figures down here, like my brother's old Minecraft figurines that I didn't want anymore. Got a stickbot skeleton that I used in the last episode. Thundercracker, Ben 10 Omnikicks armor diamond head figure. Love that guy a lot. The Omnikicks armor in the new Ben 10 series are really, really good. And we've got the BotBot overpack right there. Then we've got... What's it?
Bug on low.
And we've got some of my random paints, can of soda that I drank earlier today, some of my bottles of medication, my micron pens, and some Nixels, my Torin, some packaging tape that I used to send something to Silver with, my water bottle, and yeah, there we go. Now then, before we get on to like the exciting bit that I know you're all here for, let me show you some of the art that I have hung around my room. First up, we have Steampunk Dreams. Now this is a marvelous piece that my mom had got me during a silent auction back when I was going to high school. It is a thing of beauty. Hats off to whoever made that. You are amazing. In fact, let me just see here who it was. I cannot read that signature. Anyways, after that, I feel as though... Oh, that's my closet, by the way. Oh, hey, that's my pink elephant hat that you guys have never seen before. I got that one night at a local tavern called Firkin. They were having a promotion with the Delirium Brewery Company. Oh, and their mascot is a pink elephant. I'm tempted to believe that's their mascot... Oh, did I nab it? See, this is why I didn't want you to see my floor. It's really messy. Though not as bad as it has been in the past. But yeah, that hat was part of a promotion that Firkin was having with Delirium. So that's how I got that. Oh, and in here we have a lot of my boxes for various figures, like
I also have the box with the belt from Q-Ranger. Never, ever actually got that thing to fit around my waist, ridiculously enough.
Then down here we have some more acrylic paint, some of my equipment like my mouse, some forks that I borrowed from college to clean, some other random crap lying around here. Oh, there's my mic that I used to record the little opening text thing with the warning. The following video is, you know what I mean. Then we've got down here some of my bookshelves with some comics I like to read. I've really been liking the new series Arrow from Marvel. It's really nice. You guys should read it and buy it, totally. Then we've got some of my other books, like we've got most of the Alchemist series down here. Also got almost the entirety of Kazuke Ibuishi's Amulet series. I hope I'm pronouncing his last name correctly, because I do not know how it's pronounced. But yeah, love Amulet. That is my, has been my favorite sort of like graphic novel series from the 2000s onward. Now then, we get to a very special piece that I got from the same silent auction as Steampunk Dreams over there. And this one was actually made by a friend of mine, who I hope is watching this video right now, to so I can sort of like let you know how much this piece means to me. And that is a rooster in drag. This piece is hilarious and adorable, and I love it. Thank you for making this, Mitch. I'd like to clarify that that's Mitch with an M and not another word that sounds similar. Anyways, just to well my dresser with my equipment and so forth, we have a piece that is something that I'm astounded that I own. An original inking of one of the pages from the Archie comic Sonic the Hedgehog comics. Long story short, my family is actually friends with one of the artists who worked on Sonic the Hedgehog, well, the Archie Sonic comics. Her name is Pam Eklund, and she gave me that 1 year for my birthday. Pam, thank you so much for this. This thing honestly means a lot to me. Anyways, now I should probably get on to the stuff that you guys are the most excited for. The collection! Oh boy, here we have all of my LEGO Minecraft sets and one of my few surviving LEGO Ninjago movie sets. You can see here we have the Stronghold up here. We have Steve holding a golden sword and looking as though he's about to fall off something. Fun fact, that was actually the little LEGO thing down here is actually what I used to record a lot of my episodes after my Chromebook broke. It was just, I slotted my phone in between those two bricks and hoped for the best. Then we have the igloo, and the, I'm not sure what that is, and the Iron Golem set. We also have my own sort of like plastic representation, an OC if you will, of what I thought I would look like in Bionicle. Next up, we have my Sentai and Power Rangers stuff. So let's see here. I'm just gonna bring this over here. We have the Gemini Q-Tama from Q-Ranger, as well as a few other Q-Tama. We have the Translucent Bull and Chameleon Q-Tama, as well as the Stonecutter Q-Tama, Washi Voyager. We have Super Ninja Steel, Super Ninja Steel Mode, Blue, Yellow, and Gold. We also have Juo King. Oh man, figure. I really only recorded that episode just so I could have an episode out in time, so to speak. Not one of my best episodes. We also have the Time Q-Tama, Ninja Steel Gold, Micromorphin, this little Triceratops sword. We have Q-Rano.
Super Galaxy!
That thing is atrociously loud. Then we have Hibitsukai Voyager, so far the one and only figure to get reviewed. Anyone remembers that? Then we have Lightning Collection Magna Defender and Tenmin Voyager. Now, as you see, you spent the last night partying a bit too hard.
As did the Lionfire Armor Super Ninja Steel Red Ranger. Though Blaze, as always, is looking pretty fine. He did the responsible thing and did not go out drinking. Can't say the same. Who is he again? Aurora Travis's character. Anyways, let's move on to the top shelf of the backdrop for most of my reviews these days. Here we are. We have my Gundams, as well as a few Lego sets that I couldn't fit in up there, and some Gundams and some Transformers I couldn't fit anywhere else, and some minis. First up, we have the water skitterer thingy from the Ninjago movie. Love that set a lot, though there were way too many stickers on it. Then moving down, we have Gira Gyarga, or Giragura, Gurga, Giriga Gyagura, whatever he's pronounced, whatever that name is, I don't know. Then we have Gundam Barbados. That was the first Gundam kit I ever put together. Then we have SD Gundam Crossbones, I believe? Then we have Generations Skullgrin, the Blue Lantern down there, and one of the minis I was using for Dungeons & Dragons when I was in Dungeons & Dragons Club. We have the little dragon statue that I got from a Goodwill store at for like $3. Steal the deal that one was. We have a wooden boat that I believe my grandfather put together when I was little. We have my Kamen Rider Fives model kit, so far the only Kamen Rider model kit I have. Then we have this Gundam, who I can't remember the name of. It's Gun Cannon, I believe. Windblade, the Legends class Windblade. This thingy from Iron Blooded Orphans, I think? I don't know. Then we have my, one of the things I made in 3D Intro to Art. My, massive tree, dry brushed and everything. Then down here we have, like, bunch of random Transformers. They were basically Transformers that my brother couldn't fit anywhere else when he was organizing the collection. Oh, right there we have my hat from graduation for no particular reason. We have, Skywarp, Afterglow, I can't remember what they are. Old Punch and Direct Hit? I can't remember. Siege Spinister, that figure is lovely, though. If you haven't seen it on Twitter, I recommend you go to it because I've warned several people about all of the clear and translucent plastic issues. Here we go, let me just show you. See? The leg is got a massive stress mark on it. And it, hopefully it will survive long enough for me to make a review on it for Pride Month. I'll reveal what I'm doing for it then. Then we have Studio Series Starscream. And I remember that being the first video that I ever made that I felt totally satisfied with, so to speak. Next up, we have Prime Dead End, who will be this year's Halloween episode. We also have a Scourge, one of my other favorites from last year. One of my least favorites, Six Gun. One of the other things that I wasn't a bit mad on, honestly. The, Weaponizer, or, I mean, Battlemaster, Leonizer. Then we have, this thing. Power of the Primes, Rodimus, Unicronus. This thing is a masterpiece. And I mean that sincerely. This thing is... Mwah. I'm not sure when I'm gonna review it. I may do it for, like, 2021's Halloween episode, but I don't know. Keep it with me on that one. Then we have, down at his feet, G1 Rumble, and we also have G1 Laserbeak. We also have a, RID 2015 Twinferno that I tried to repaint, because I didn't like it. And now that's called another OC that I made called Firefall, who I will be giving to Silver at TF Nation 2020, hopefully. Just beneath him we have Titans Return Nightbeat. And we also have an incomplete GoBot scooter that my brother found for me at his art therapy
voices. Love you, bro. Then we have a transmetal air razor. That thing is lovely. I still haven't got the pontoon for it, though. We need to get the pontoon.
Oh, right. And behind Rodimus Unicrosis' big, fat thighs, we have Patero. Then, beyond that, we have Titan's Return, Trigger Happy. Man, I really wish I had gotten the video for that one better than this, the one I had actually made of it. Anyways, moving on down, we have the next shelf in my collection. We have Titan's Return Croc, who is unfortunately missing one of the weird flaps for his claws, so I can't review him. Then we've got Gobot's Hans Cuff, one of the dumbest names in the universe, but I still love him nonetheless. Thank you, Lee. Then we've got my Power of the Prime Scrapnel. Wingspan, actually. Wingspan from Titan's Return. And just beneath this guy, we have Retrax. Yes, Beast Wars Unicron himself. The subject of a future and most likely hilarious review, because, fun fact, I'm not actually going to have anything bad to say about that figure. I think it's hilarious, honestly. It's one of the funniest figures I've ever owned. And that is why I do not hate him, even though he is not good. Next up, we have Obsidian from RID 2001, and underneath him we have Titan's Return Sea Spray. Then we have Titan's Return Cosmos. War for Cybertron Siege, Skytread, the top half. Then we have the Micromasters from War for Cybertron Siege. We have Visper and... God, I can't remember the other one's name. Then we have Apeface. Oh man, that thing was fun to review. I didn't learn until recently that the white plastic isn't actually plastic. It's actually super compressed nylon. Weirdly enough. Then we have Titan's Return Soundwave, or at least the Bumblebee repaint of Titan's Return Soundwave. Then we have Siege Soundwave, who again has spent the night out partying like an irresponsible jackass. Then we have all of my monster transformers. I don't know why they're organized like this, especially. We have Gnaw back there, who is a lovely thing of beauty. Who I unfortunately haven't done anything about. Might change while I'm at college, honestly. Then we've got Cyberverse Legion, or Battle Class, is it? Shockwave? Love that Legends Class Shockwave, by the way. He will be appearing in many of my future photo shoots down here in the photo box. Did I grab it? Alongside some of my other figures. Here we have the two halves of Weaponizer Cog. Back there we have Battle Slash. Then underneath Sea Spray we have Deep Dive. Weird thing about that figure is that I don't get why it's an Autobot. Just hear me out for a second. Pokemon Deep Dive seems a bit too dark and moody for a Decepticon now, doesn't it? I'm just checking here. Does anyone else agree with me? Leave a like if you agree with me in this circumstance. Yeah, whatever. Still like him as a figure, though. And I'm still missing the missiles from him. But I don't see that as an issue. Like I've said before, I will only not review a figure if it is missing an accessory that is vital to its vehicle mode. And I don't see missiles as particularly vital to vehicle modes. I also forgot to mention we have two of the Power of the Prime's Abomnus characters. We have Rippersnapper and Blot. Repugnus back there. Oh man, thanks for reviewing that with me, Silver. That was amazing. Then we have Titan's Return Twinferno. Down here we have G1 Ravage and G1 Frenzy. Then over here we have Power of the Prime's Slash. Man, I do not know what I was on when I reviewed that figure. I think I was just exhausted. Then we have Hole Punch and Caliburst, I believe, from Scoop, who is a shelf below. Then we have Power of the Prime is Bludgeon. Titan's Return, I don't know who the heck that is. Starfox? I don't know. Then we have
Power of the Prime is Submarauder, Landmine. Is it, I think that's Landmine? Or is it, I don't remember who that is. And then we have Power of the Prime is Skullgren. Not to be confused,
Deluxe Skullgren up here.
Okay, then, let's move on down to the final shelf here. Or penultimate shelf, I guess. We have a bunch of my land vehicles that my brother put here in vehicle mode because he is awesome. Please give him a hell yeah in the comments. First off, we have Mirage. Then we have Red Alert and... God, what was his name? Sideswipe. Reveal the Shield, the G2 Optimus. Siege Brunt. Titans Return Breakaway. Not particularly popular, as I understand it. Titans Return Hot Rod with his guns on top like an idiot. Then we have Power of the Prime's Couch Punter Couch. I mean, Punch Counter Punch. Sorry, Theo. Then we've got... what was his name again? Soundwave. R.I.D. Deluxe Soundwave. R.I.D. Deluxe Blur. Deluxe Ratchet from Siege. Deluxe Dirt Boss from Cybertron. Still my only Cybertron figure. Actual Cybertron figure. Then we have Swindler, is it Road Handler? I don't know. Then we have Hound. Siege Crosshairs. Siege Ironhide. Siege Prime. Scoop from Thrilling 30. Titans Return B. R.I.D. 2015 Optimus Prime, the super powered one. Studio Series Ironhide, a thing of true beauty. The bottom half of Skytread. Road Trap, Springer. Don't really like that figure, honestly. I mean, it is decent, but it ain't special like Ape Faces. There we've got Tailgate. Fortunately, his little windscreen up here has been cracked, so I can't really transform him. Then we've got Power of the Prime's Beachcomber. Studio Series Bone Crusher. Really love that figure. Siege Megatron. R.I.D. 2001 X-Brawn and Scourge. Big Shot. Or Top Shot, rather. Then we have Voyager, Power of the Prime's Inferno. Up top we have Titans Return Hardhead, and Mr. Meme Lord himself. Siege Leader Class. Siege Leader Class, Galaxy Upgrade, Optimus Prime. Then down here we have, like I said earlier, some other Transformers and stuff I couldn't fit in. Here we have Carkick, who... I unfortunately was going to review, but last week because Front told me he was kind of boring, and that kind of put me off reviewing him. But yeah, I almost forgot. Down here we have all the Transformers that I'm going to sell on eBay because I don't like them. That, I believe, is the last of the figures in my collection. Oh right, almost forgot. Here is one of my two art finals from last semester. It's, Hirobi running away in fear from Kamen Rider 01, who's jumping into the air and about to kick him, while, Jin is in the middle ground, and Izu and a trampoline are in the background. Isn't that lovely? I think. If we're doing tags in this video, then I'd like to tag, the YouTubers Silver Gamer, Dr. Lockdown, and of course, the Lazy Eyebrow Reviewer to also undertake this same challenge. So guys, that was sort of my tour for 2020. I hope you all enjoyed the video, and will let me know what you think of it down in the description. I don't expect this to be the most viewed episode of it, figures, honestly, and I don't even expect it to bring in a lot of subscribers. I just did it because I wanted to, and didn't have anything better to do. So with that being said, this is Rabbi 27, over and out.